Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are back again with the next on one-on-one series of OSPAS India in continuation to our OSPAS award, which were recently held in the month of August in India in association with BW Business World and media partners BW Security World, BW Police World, BW Defense and Security Link India. We have had other interactions with the other panelists, but today we have somebody who is actually not from the industry, and we requested her to moderate a session which was full of women in security panelists diversified in their various fields, and she did it wonderfully. And I think today's talk with her is going to be very interesting for me and for everybody else who is watching this video to learn. Please allow me to welcome Sonal Jindal. Sonal,
thank you, Rajiv.
Before we start, a brief introduction about yourself so that we all know that we are talking to a woman who is not a security professional about women who are into the security as their profession. Sonal.
Okay. Hi, everyone. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Rajiv, to OSPAS Business World for inviting me on today's one-on-one talk show and discussion about our previous panel and about the security industry. Definitely, as by the introduction, I am not from the security industry. I am from the fashion world, and I'm an entrepreneur from the fashion world. I started my career in the fashion world. I'm a businesswoman. I run three companies. Two are from the fashion industry, and one is a consultancy firm. And this is the first time when I got an opportunity to speak to women from the security industry, and it was an amazing panel. I got to learn so many things from all the panelists, from Himani, from Rupal ji, from Monica, and from Ila, and all of them, they had so much to teach me that it was an eye-opener. Thank you, Rajiv, for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you. Wonderful, wonderful opening remarks from you. So now you have met, interacted, spoken to the women in security. What do you think about the challenges that women in security face, and how do you think they can overcome those challenges from your perspective?
See, from my perspective, what I learned from the panel and from the discussion before the panels, from all the panelists, I think I could learn from Himani that the preconceived notion with which women are perceived in security, where you know, the preconceived notion that they won't be able to hold the stakeholders' engagement, how they would connect with the administration. It will be very difficult for them to handle the mob gathering. It will be very difficult for them to handle the police and likewise jobs. And I think it is about the mindset which I could gather as per Himani, that it is a very outdated preconceived notion. With time and with leadership style in security domain, these women, they have produced beneficial results for their own organization. And as all the panelists like Ila, Rupal, Monica mentioned, that there is an urgency to redesign the job roles and implementation of gender nuclear recruitment process to task female security professional to their optimum capacity level. Rajiv, today in morning I was attending the Economic Times Women's Forum, and though there was Sania Mirza, she opened the forum. It was very interesting to understand that how at 6 she started her career, at 33 how she, after being a mother, how she, you know, she's facing the challenge, you know, that she had put on 23 kgs weight, and her own friends, they say, I don't think so, you can go back to your career. But then she proved them wrong. And she said, but these are all the preconceived notions which are there in the society. So there was this very interesting, and I think you should get in touch with these nuns from Himalayas. They call themselves Kung Fu nuns. and they are a Buddhist Drukpa nuns, and they are into martial arts. They are strong women. They believe in proactive, things which they are doing for their community. They are helping others. So if the Buddhist nuns can redesign themselves, why can't women in security, why can't women in sports, why can't women in digital world, why can't women in world, redesign themselves? It is very important to redesign. And I think I would like to quote here a very nice adage by Beyonce. We need to reshape our perception of how we view ourselves. We have to step up as women and take the lead. And I truly believe that we are the change. So I think these are the things we need to overcome.
Fantastic. Fantastic, Sonal. Wonderful. So what you just stated is so wonderful to hear from you. And this is, I'm glad that this is perhaps the contribution is that panel discussion that you participated in, that you moderated rather. Now, my next question is a little tricky here. So how do you think your perception has changed about women in security? How was it earlier and how is it now after moderating that session? Has it changed? Has it not changed? What are your thoughts?
Yes, definitely my perception has changed because I myself has used women security officers, though I don't need a protection, but at times, you're going for an event and you feel that it's late night, and I have had female security officers with me, but I had no idea about, especially I was very impressed by Rupal ji and Himani, that how from their army background they join security and how there are opportunities for women in security, not only on a ground level but in a in an office level, in an executive level. So that perception has been changed, because in my head it was always men might be doing that role, but yes, all of them, especially Himani and Rupal ji, they changed my perspective about that.
Wonderful. I'm sure through this video, all the compliments that are going to all those women who were the panelists would go to them as well. Himani was recently also, was felicitated with an award at a separate function, by the way. So I'm sure she will watch this and she'll be happy about what.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Colonel Himani.
All right. So having said that, now what do you think, what all roles women can play in terms of security? What all can they do in security?
I think like what Ila said and what Monica is doing, she's a part of cybersecurity and she's a good hacker. That's one of the interesting roles women can do. And Ila is a senior risk management advisor. She asserted the inclusive approach of involve women into the domain companies, which must focus on inclusive job descriptions for female employees and their hiring procedures. The cybersecurity domain, I think, is a very important domain where women can be part of that domain. So according to her, there are unfulfilled jobs. There are around 1.8 million jobs which are there. And most of these are being holded by men. Men are there. I think women, that is one job which women can definitely do. So that's what I believe. And the executive level jobs like what Rubal ji is doing and what Himani is doing, those are the jobs they can definitely, apart from, the basic security officer, these are the jobs women can do.
Yeah, and now even in our forces, women are also playing an important role on the front line as well.
Yeah, so I think women can protect men also in the
front. Of course, yes. My next question, I generally discuss this, and I'm a firm believer, but I would like to know from you, is it all right, is it even all right to actually have this discussion called Women in Security as a topic. Should this be ever a topic of discussion? You know, that, you know, how women play an important role, women in security, let's give them award because she's a woman in the security. Does it happen in your industry? That's my second question. Do you think, my first question I repeat, and I'm very interested to know in detail on this question. Do you think the valid point is a valid topic to have a discussion or a panel discussion saying that let's discuss role of women in security, what the challenges do they face? Is it a valid topic? The second, does it happen in the other industry? Does it happen in fashion industry? Women in fashion industry, let's discuss about that. Your thoughts, please, Sonu.
Okay, so I am working towards women empowerment. I'm working towards gender equality. And Rajiv, according to the UN Women, it'll take 99.5 years, approximately 100 years for gender equality. So definitely this is one topic which should be discussed on your platform and other platforms. Because we need progressive men. When we met also, I think that time also I mentioned you that it's a combination of a man and woman, you know, and we need progressive men. We need organizations which support women, you know, to come up. And I think if there are women in security, this will give motivation to other women to join this as a profession, because according to me, I would not have thought of this as a profession, but yes, I can think of it as a profession. Other women can also think of it as a profession, especially the sports, you know, the women who are in sports, they can think this as a profession. But yes, if you are not going to talk about these topics, then how would they know that this is one profession which is there for them? So I think that's very important. In my career, I have faced gender inequality, and that has been a biggest challenge. As per the fashion industry, the fashion word is a very feminine word, and it is related to women. And it is in world, in global market, it is more female dominated word. It is good for the independent entrepreneurs. I have worked with approximately 2,000 designers who are into garment business, who are into jewelry business, who are into decorative business. But these are not the challenges are not faced by them, you know, because they are small business, independent business owners. So they have their female, the male support from family, who somebody is supporting them, you know. So they don't face that kind of a challenge. But when we talk about on executive level, on a corporate level, yes, there is definitely a gender inequality is there. So I'm part of CIIWN, and there has been a survey, and I would like to read out from that survey. That survey was done in collaboration with Ernst & Young, with CIIWN. As per in the survey, there are 16% respondent reported that having no women on the board, and 47% reported that there are no more than 5% women in senior management roles. So the women in the senior management role are very less. So when we did the panel discussion also, these were the women from the senior management, you know. So they are only 5%. And we are not talking about the security industry. We are talking about the global industry, right? So the senior role is only 5%. Some of the major challenges that hinder the progress of diversity and inclusive initiative included unconscious bias, ineffective implementation of policies, fewer women in leadership roles, lack of awareness about the benefits of gender diversity. You won't believe, I was a housewife before starting a business. I wasn't aware of law. I wasn't aware about my rights. And there are so many women in this country who are not aware of gender diversity. They are not aware of their basic rights, you know. They are being taught the duties. They are not aware of their basic rights. It's very important to understand law. It's very important for women to understand about gender diversity. And according to the survey, there are 42% female respondents who said that they face managerial bias. This bias is known to be present at the senior levels and affects the growth of women in the workplace. Moreover, 33% female respondents believe that there are different performance standards and expectations from male and female employees working at the same level. So see, the expectation from a female employee is so different from the male employee. The report further noted that 69% of the organization have been unable to understand the financial benefits of diversity because women are not financially aware. So at the age of 13, 14, a boy is a man, but a girl is a girl. Till she gets married, she's naive. She's unaware of financial finances, you know. So that plays a role in the diversity also. So diversity and inclusion policy implementation is crucial and need to be monitored by senior management to assess the efficiency of the same. The survey came from the 17 states from multiple sectors like service, manufacturing, IT, pharma, healthcare, education, fashion, and agriculture. You know, so that's not in one sector, that's in all the sectors. It's not only in security, it's not only in fashion, it's not only in IT. It is in global, global platform. I travel a lot for my work. I travel to Europe, to America. I have felt gender inequality in Europe, and that too big time. I don't think so. I have ever felt that kind of a gender inequality in India, but in Italy, I did at one of the meetings. I did feel that. So I think these are the things. Which will take time, but it can be changed. Yeah.
So wonderful, Sonal. So wonderful perspective that you have given about the professional women and the inequality, and that you have faced the examples that you have given, and wonderful statistics that you shared with us. I don't know if that report that you have read the details from can be shared.
I'll share it with you.
Yeah, if you can share it with me, we'll try to share it with the audience, and I'm sure they would get benefited out of it. Before we come to the closing of this session, Sonal, any closing remarks from you?
Yeah, since a very eminent personality from gender equality, the one lady who was working towards gender equality passed away few days back. So I want to quote Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. She said the real change, enduring change happen one step at a time. And I think if we take small steps, that change will happen. And I personally believe that my oath is that I am that change and I want to be that change. So that's wonderful. How I want to.
Wonderful, yeah. wonderful.
Thank you.
And I think this session is perhaps one of the best that we had in the recent times. And
thank you.
Look forward to have more of your time, Sonal, as and when you can give us, and as and when any next opportunity would come. Now at least I know that we're all I can have your views, and I can invite you to share your thoughts with the larger audience. With that note, thank you so much once again, Sonal, and thank you everyone for watching this one-on-one with Sonal Jindal. And if you have any queries, you can write to us, and on behalf of Sonal, I assure you that we'll have an answer from Sonal. And the report that she just mentioned is also available in this note. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sonal, once again, and take care.
Thank you, Rajiv. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.